He's talking about the strategic importance of his village to the Palestinian resistance.
As I see, it's 600 persons. We have a high percentage of high education in Palestine, high percentage of parties. The first intifada unified leadership who established this from Rabbi Saleh. The culture of resistance is part of daily of our life. We have open mentality for the participating with the women for that. It's easy. We want to create a model, as I told you, like the first intifada, everyone participated. And we want to unify also the other villages who struggle against the building of the wall. And we don't want to take about the specific code. It's the settlement of the wall. The settlement of the wall, as I said, it's the shape of the problem. We're talking about the occupation as a central problem and the general problem for that. Our strategy is to indicate for this mean to convince our society to take this mean to be a belief and strategy and the answer for our way of resistance.
So I'm going to preface this, sir, with I'm fairly ignorant of the situation in that part of the world. So maybe what I'm saying is completely off base, what I'm asking is completely off base, but as a ignorant American as to what's going on over there, I am very interested in that part of the world and what's been going on. I've read that, and maybe this is just conspiracy theory ridiculousness, I just wanted to see your point of view on it. I've read and heard a little bit that the PLO was more moderate than Hamas, and that one of the things that some people have highlighted or pointed out, and maybe it's complete bold, maybe it's not real, maybe it's not true, is that, and by the way, I'm not saying that you're associated with Hamas at all or anything like that, but I've heard people say that actually in the early 80s, Hamas was funded initially by the State of Israel, and that was when the PLO was a lot more, had a lot more sway. So I guess my question is do you have any knowledge of this? Is there any legitimacy to that? And I would like to hear you speak on the fact that perhaps it was a tactic of the State of Israel to edge out the PLO being more secular, more moderate, and actually utilizing Hamas as a mechanism to justify what they're doing to the Palestinian people. Thank you.
Firstly, we have the right to resist the enemy. And who is the terrorist is the occupation. And who, if somebody see Hamas as a terrorist group or make a terrorist attack as everyone identified that, I think who pushed the Palestinian to this side is the occupation. The man that create all the terrorists all over the world is the existing of Israel. The world suffering the existing of Israel. Israel, as I told you, is the greenhouse for implanting the extreme and terrorists all over the world. For us as a Palestinian, I believe in non-violent resistance. But I believe also we have the right to resist. In any means, this is the international law. know if it's really Israel support Hamas or not. Hamas is part of the Islamic Brotherhood. And the Islamic Brotherhood is they are not existing in 1987. It's existing in 1929 in Egypt and all the Palestinian region. For me, I am not a religious person. I don't asking for or feeling about any religious way of thinking. But it's the right for everyone to do his belief, because he has the right, and he suffered a lot, and they push him to explode himself. It was a big examination for me. And this, when I saw all my family under that soldier, I got to bring a stone and put it on the head of this soldier. And I have the right to do anything. But this is I really believe that I must be patient and must be strong and strengthen my belief the way that I ask my population to do. I must be patient. And if I do, I can take the soldier and beat him alone. And this means that he will kill one and everybody comes in my heart. I think it was a hard examination. Because of all of that, if we will want to end what you want to call terrorist, resistant, revolution, extreme, we must end the occupation.